Monica, come on, wait up. Come on. What, you want me to hobble all the way to you? Come on. Slow down. Look, I'm sorry, okay?
Don't you at least want to say hi to anyone?
I mean, I don't even know this kid.
Yes, you do. He was the kid who did magic tricks.
Magic tricks?
Yeah.
That guy?
Yeah.
That dude, what the fuck? Are you serious? He was like the weirdest kid.
When did he become friends with anyone?
Fine. Don't come.
Oh, come on, Monica. Come here. Come here. Come here. I'm sorry. I just wish things were like they used to be, you know?
I know. But I hear James's place is kind of amazing, so how about we go? And if it's lame, I'll make an excuse and we'll get out of there. Okay?
Deal. I knew there was a reason I liked you.
My ass.
Two reasons.
That's the house? Did the kid win the lottery or something?
Monica? Bryce? Oh my god. It's so good to see you guys.
Hi.
Becca.
Yeah, it's been too long.
Wow, you look great.
Thanks. You'd be surprised what a little exercise and a new dress can do.
Butterball Becca. Seriously, a little exercise?
Look at you two, still together. Why don't you come inside?
Hey, Butterball, I thought I told you to clean up this trash. Oh, excuse me. Bryce, glad you could make it.
Hey, thanks,
Monica.
James, this place looks fucking amazing.
Oh, thanks. Hey, you look amazing.
I could help.
Do you need some help with that?
That would be
great. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Your house is crazy.
Uh-oh! Looks like trouble just showed up!
Jesus Christ.
Bro, I haven't seen you since. Just forget about it. You're on 2 feet.
Getting strong every day with something.
I haven't seen anyone since graduation.
Yeah, same here. It's so great. Whatever happened to you acting? I thought you were gonna move out to Los Angeles. And did you know that I'm out there now? It's fabulous.
Yeah, you know, things change. I'm just glad that I could be here for Bryce after what happened.
What? Oh, yeah, the car crash thing?
Yeah. Neat trick.
I've got a feel.
So how are things at State, man?
Good. Good, man. Good. I'm not gonna lie. They're in desperate need of a new QB. So I'm already starting. It's unreal. Not a day goes by where I don't think about you, brother. I mean, what a freak accident, right?
Speaking of freak, I mean, when did James all of a sudden become cool? I mean, didn't you just like beat the shit out of that kid in high school?
He's a good guy. I mean, when I needed help with something, he was there.
I'm gonna go grab a beer. You guys want anything?
seen Monica?
Monica?
Ever hear of knocking?
Oh, sorry. Have you seen Monica?
No. Have you?
Hey, have you guys seen Monica? My girlfriend? No. Hey, you haven't seen Monica, right? I haven't seen Monica. No. Okay. Hey, have you guys seen Monica? She's curly hair, my girlfriend. No? No one's seen her?
The number you dialed is not in service. Welcome to the Cool Kids Club.
Cool Kids Club?
You know. You and the other kids who ate in the quad. I always wondered what it would be like to sit with you guys. Just once. I fantasized about it. Now I'm in it. James is in it. The freaks are running the show.
I mean, it wasn't anything special. It was just, like, lunch.
Yeah, well. Fantasy is always better than reality.
I'm still with Monica.
Who?
Hey, tell me. Have you seen Monica? No? Hey, have you guys seen Monica, my girlfriend? No? Okay. Awesome. Oh, hey. Where's Monica? I mean, after you guys were talking in the kitchen, where'd she go?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Wow. Okay. Really? Really? No one knows where Monica is!
I think you might have had too much to drink. Maybe you should go home. Sleep it off.
No. Fuck that. I'm not going anywhere without her. What the fuck is going on with all of you?
Man, what the hell, Hector?
When did you become a kid, bitch? You're bumming everyone out. Just go home, man.
No! I'm not going anywhere without Monica.
You're acting weird!
I'm acting weird! But she just suddenly disappears, and then James is
I told you to shut up about James!
Get off of me!
So you flip your car, man, it sucks. But that's like your fault, right? It's not my fault to be the one who stepped up for the team.
What does that have to do with James, man?
Nothing. I'm drunk. Just fucking go home,
no,
man!
No! Come on. I'm your friend, man. Tell me what's going on.
Come on.
Talk to me.
The fuck is up? Before your accident, he came to me, and he said he wanted to make a deal. He said I could be the one starting the game in front of those scouts. You missed the game, and I started.
What, are you saying this is James' fault? Own the fuck up, Hector!
Fuck you. He was freaking out, okay? I just did you a favor.
No, I do the favors. You people just fuck it up.
I'm done.
No, that's not how this works. We made a deal, remember? I held up my end. Do I have to remind you of yours? See?
Stop! No more fucking lies, man! Where is she?
Who? Bryce, you really gotta watch that temper.
What are you?
Hector, buddy? Glasses.
Fuck. What did you do to her?
Me? Maybe you should be asking yourself that question.
Monica? Monica? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Come on! Look off me! Hey, stop!
Doesn't have to. You really think all the good shit that's been happening around here to everyone is a fucking coincidence? I can make all of this go away. I can help you like I've helped everyone else. You just walk out that door, and it'll be like none of this ever happened.
Why me?
Because we're friends, Bryce. That's what friends do.
Monica?
Ever hear of knocking?
Oh, sorry. Have you seen Monica?
No. Have you? And as I was saying to our dear friend Hector here, a deal is a deal. Even if you don't like how I make it happen. Now, as for Monica.
Who's Monica?
Glenn.
Huh?
I saw that little smile he gave you. Are you guys fucking?
No.
Why not?
We hung out like once.
So?
Smiles up. Let's go, gents. Get out of here. Ladies, come on. Come on. All right. I want the guys in the back, girls in front. Come on.
Where so are what? Are you just smiles, being a
gents?
Tease?
Give me some smiles.
No.
Come on.
No.
Hi. Ladies, we're going to make them win.
Hey.
Hi.
So I was thinking maybe we could hang out tonight, just the two of us. Parking lot after practice.
Okay, ladies, yearbook committee's here to take pictures. You knew it. Can you give me a go, Magpies?
Go, Magpies!
Okay.
Hey, babe. Meet me in the parking lot.
Shut up. It's not that big a deal.
Oh, come on. He's so into you.
Stop.
No, seriously. Okay, you have to call me later and tell me everything, okay?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Jesus Christ.
Hi, Glenn. Oh, hi, Glenn.
Laurie, are you in here?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not peeking. I'm totally not. So, what happened to meeting me in the parking lot?
Oh, no, I was just about to head over there.
It's okay. Hey, you want to see something cool? Swim?
What?
Come on, there's nobody here. It's okay. It's just water, relax.
Rory! How much longer am I gonna be here?
Well, since the time that I wasted with you two in the principal's office was supposed to be spent grading papers, maybe that's how much longer you owe me. That, or until you two want to tell me what this is all about.
Ask her. She's the one that rushed me while I was standing in front of the class, calling me a cunt.
Excuse me.
Reading from a report which not only needs a spell check, but was directed squarely at Clubber Lang here.
Look, if she took what I wrote personally, that's her problem.
And mine is that you're using class time to threaten somebody with the wrath of some bargain bin local ghost, made up of the hands of the missionary settlers it slaughtered while they were in prayer. Okay, look, I know that you students think us teachers are uptight and preachy and all thou shalt not, but it wasn't that long ago that we were right where you are. And some of us care enough to keep our ear to the ground. We hear what's being said, Mallory.
Well, you can't control who you fall in love with. Isn't that right? And look, I get it. You don't take what I wrote seriously because you're new here. But the story's been around forever. That it all starts by seeing things from the corner of your eye. Things you're ashamed of and would do anything to forget. But you can't stop them. That's Rue. Haunting you. Festering you for slaughter. And when it finally comes, you can't scream. Nothing comes out your mouth. It's like in a nightmare. You can't scream. But yeah, you're right. The lot say it's just some stupid story people tell around the campfire. But you didn't get to hear my conclusion before I was punched in the face. Whether or not it's true, Rue is guilt. And that, I know for sure, is real.
Look, don't let her get to you. Okay, she's just messing with your head because she's angry. Because she likes you more than a friend should, and you're not willing to reciprocate that. All right, she's the one that should be feeling guilty. She's the one that this ghost would be after. I mean, nothing bad is gonna happen just because you regret things. But I need to know, what did you tell her?
I love you. I love you.
Why'd you do this? Why?
Hey.
Thank you. I'm not gonna make it. We're sitting on the fire pit. Shut your eyes, girl. It's getting pretty spooky here. Well, let me make it crystal clear. This is a cry for help. This is a cry for help.
Now I'm going to tell you a story. The year was 1980. Camp Not Gonna Make It opened. The first campers were learning arts and crafts, survival skills. There was one child who stood out among them. Nobody knew his real name. They just called him Squirt.
Squirt? Oh! He sounds like a geek!
Not only was he a geek, he was also horribly disfigured.
That's awful.
The only thing worse was how the other children treated him. So he hid best he could. Now, if you were horribly disfigured in 1980, whose face would you use to cover it up?
Burt Reynolds, of course.
Squirt wore a Burt Reynolds mask the entire summer, only to take it off when he slept. But one night, while he slumbered in his bunk, a bunch of kids filled the mask with steaming hot honey glue. They woke Squirt up, telling him there was an emergency. And as he frantically put on his mask, the one thing that he thought could protect him burned the skin right off his face. He ran into the woods and was never seen again.
Cool story, Chet. Very original. So nobody knows what happened to him?
Legend has it he took refuge in the abandoned Camp Fitness Center. No one was ever going to call him Squirt Reynolds again. Make sure of that. From then on, any campers unlucky enough to set eyes on him wouldn't laugh. They would cry out in terror. If you close your eyes and listen carefully, they say you can hear the clanging of dumbbells as Squirt gets in a late-night pump.
Hey, girl. You want to work out with me?
No.
I could really use it. I'm working up a nice sweat.
Why don't you eat a dick?
I don't eat dicks. Seriously, Lana, come on. It's just some good old-fashioned camp shenanigans. Lana! Fuck! Whatever.
I'm gonna go check on her.
Trey, are you smoking a doobie? It's a doobie. I've been around the block.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Now that you're here. What was that?
Nothing.
No, I heard something.
Yeah. Squirt Reynolds?
Yeah!
Hey, I was playing a song, man.
More of a guitar guy.
Spooky here. Well, let me make it crystal clear.